all, thank you so much for stopping to talk to us.
Of course.
I just wanted to ask you, you work on BYU, which is one of my favorites. What made you want to attach yourself to here?
Well, it was frightening and exciting at the same time. And I thought, at this point in my life, it's my fifth movie, you know, I'm attracted to things that are a little bit frightening and intimidating and worth doing, you know. And so, I don't know, I mean, it felt like a no-brainer, you know.
And you've been in front of the camera before as well.
Yeah.
So if you could play any iconic woman in history yourself, who would you play?
Oh, wow. I have not thought about that.
No.
In history, I want to play Toni Morrison.
Oh my gosh, that would be amazing.
Yeah.
That would be so amazing. Oh my goodness.
But I don't know if I can do it justice. I mean, she was one of my absolute heroes, and she's a shining light in my life and really, really inspirational to me.
Maybe that's the next time.
Yeah, that's the next film.
Yeah.
And finally, before you get out of here, what advice would you give to young women of color trying to break into the film industry as writers, as directors, and even producers?
It's about tenacity, okay? Nobody's going to make it easy for us. It's about tenacity. It's like the last man standing, you know. You have to know yourself and know whether you have a personality for it. But if you have something to say, say it yourself. Your what you have to say. Don't try and guess what people want to hear. Don't try and guess what the audience might like. You talk from your heart. What is important to you? What moves you?
See, Harriet, women, we have to support this. It's valuable that we go out and support our own. So.
Hitting all the ones that's currently spitting. We got Jamissi smitten, rubbing on a little kitten, dreaming up a world that's equal for women with no division.